welcome back, folks. And I'd like to say welcome to our NCTV audience. This is Rick Haggerty, Kickin' It for Peace, Culture, and Education, airing each Sunday morning from 8 to 10 a.m. right here at 103.3 FM, Valley Free Radio, streaming online at valleyfreeradio.org. And we're so happy to have our NCTV audience with us. And welcome back, Valley Free Radio listeners as well. So why don't we introduce our guest? And I'm having so much fun playing with the cameras here, guys. So we've got Emily is here, and this is Emily Fable, Program Lead at Center for Ecotechnology and Green Team Program Administrator, and CJ McCarthy, my colleague at STEM Middle Academy in Springfield. And guys, get right up to the mics. How you doing this morning?
Great, thanks.
Doing excellent, thank you.
All right, fantastic. So we want to talk about so many things, and you know, it was great that what we heard from Yale Climate Connections had to do with somebody coming into schools, because that's what CJ and I do. Aside from being teachers, you know, we work with the Green Team, and you've got a whole network of schools. And why don't you talk a little bit about that Green Team program?
Yeah, first of all, I'll give a little background about what the Green Team is.
So, great.
I work for CET, or the Center for Ecotechnology. We're an environmental nonprofit with a main office right here in Florence. And we administer a wide variety of programs, all helping people and businesses save energy and reduce waste. And one of those programs is the Green Team. The Green Team is a program funded by the Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection, and it is a program, statewide program, there to help schools and teachers with environmental initiatives at their schools and teaching students about environmental issues.
Yeah, it's so much fun doing that. I mean, you know, CJ and I have been at it for quite a while now. How long have you been doing that?
At least 3 years now, I believe. Two solid years. Three, I think we started with the students initially, but only 2 years as the Green Team, I think, officially.
Yeah, and we'll talk about the specifics of that a little bit later, right? So, and how many schools are in that network, did you say?
It varies each year, but usually 300 to 400 schools will sign up.
It's incredible.
Yeah.
It's such a fantastic thing.
You know,
thanks,
it's great.
Thanks so much for doing that. You know, one thing we have noticed, I'll say before we go on, not only is it an awesome thing to do in a school, but every child that's involved, you know, when the parents come in for parent conferences, I'll mention that they're involved with the Green Team. They'll say, yes, I know, we recycle everything in the home. You know, it really spreads.
Yes, yeah, definitely. That's the one thing that's very exciting about working with students on these issues, is they learn them and they take them back to their homes and their communities.
Yes, absolutely. All right, so let's take a look at recent updates. What's going on at CET Online? How about that?
Let's say Green Team.
Green Team, yeah. So
Green Team,
Green Team updates, sure thing. Okay.
So the Green Team, it's got, you know, it's a regular program, goes on every year, and over time we try to do small improvements to help the program get better and better. One thing we've done recently is the Massachusetts Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, MassDESE. You guys are probably more familiar with them than me. They occasionally update their curriculums, the frameworks and things. And so we've recently realigned our activities through the Green Team so they match up with the current English language arts, nice, mathematics, and science and technology and engineering frameworks. So teachers using these activities know how to line them up with the curriculum stuff that they need to be doing anyway.
That's a great resource.
Yeah, totally, yeah.
Yeah. Also, we're doing some new things this year that haven't rolled out yet, but we're really excited for them coming up. One is, you know, a lot of schools, what they're focused on right now is getting the waste from their cafeterias and diverting that from the trash, because a lot of the waste coming out of schools is coming right out of their cafeteria, and a lot of that is food waste. And food waste doesn't need to go in the trash. In fact, it shouldn't. It things that are unopened and uneaten can potentially be eaten by someone else. And things that are opened and scraps and, you know, things that kids decide they didn't really want to eat, those can be sent to like a compost site or another method of turning into either compost or energy. So we recently filmed a couple schools up in Franklin County, Four Corners Elementary in Greenfield and Northfield Elementary School, to see what they're doing in their cafeteria, because all the schools up there are doing a really nice job diverting all of their waste in their cafeteria from disposal. And that video, as soon as it's ready, will be available on our website so schools can watch and see a really good example of what it looks like to divert that material from disposal.
Fantastic.
Fantastic, yeah. And I hope to see our STEM Middle Academy photos, which I sent your way.
Yeah,
I've got more, by the way.
Yeah, we put one in the newsletter, I think, and hopefully the rest are on our website. I haven't checked yet, but they should be soon if they're not yet.
Yeah, well, it's so fantastic. I mean, you know, this curriculum alignment, it's great, you know, for science. I mean, language arts, for sure.
Yeah, being able to use
something
like that in the classroom, just having access to it as a teacher, not necessarily having to go and seek out those resources, but being able to use engaging activities in the classroom really brings students into it, and it brings the work home with them, like you mentioned earlier.
Yeah, totally. And we've got a pretty good, student involvement in the Green Team there as well, and we can talk more about that. But
yeah, definitely.
What about video on what is the video on cafeteria?
That's what I was just saying.
Okay. So now light bulb
that
activity.
Might be a good one since we have a science teacher in the room. We've had an activity on our website about light bulbs, and it was looking at comparing incandescent and CFLs, so fluorescent bulbs. But now we're at the point where LEDs are much more predominant and the better choice. They're more energy efficient.
Sure.
They don't have the mercury. So we're updating that activity right now. Fantastic. So it compares all three types of light bulbs.
Great.
So that'll be posted very soon. And it's a nice little math exercise, science exercise, to understand the energy difference and also the cost savings between using different types of light bulbs.
I could use that in a seventh grade classroom for sure.
Yeah. Well, you know, I did the switch out with the mass energy audit in my home, and every single light bulb in my home was transformed to an LED.
Uh-huh. And that's fantastic.
And
you don't need to change light bulbs all the time once you have LEDs.
They last
for a really long time. Right.
Well, you know, I talked to our maintenance director about that, and he was looking at it and considering certain lights becoming LED, and I couldn't remember if he was talking about wondering where he could get them or what he would do. So, is that something that you change up in schools, or we just have to kind of go on our own, or you educate
that's
us?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
As far as the actual light bulbs, we don't deal with changing them. But if you have questions, you should call us. I can probably connect you with a resource to help.
Sure.
Focus so much more on waste. I don't always know all the resources we have for energy-related issues, but we probably have something we can point your way for more information.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
I mean, more than anything, I just like to see the lights turned off. more often at the end of the day, I'm like walking by, like turning off lights.
Yeah.
But, maintenance, there's a second shift of maintenance, and, they come in at one point, so they have to do their cleaning as well, so see what they're doing. All right, so updated library.
Green Team, we've long had on our website something called the Green Team Library. It used to, quite a while ago, be an actual physical library. We had a box of books, and people could request them, and we'd mail them out to people. But over time, that kind of hasn't been used as much. People are able to find so many more things online and access resources other ways. So what we're doing right now is we're creating a more virtual version of our library, updating the materials, bringing in some more recent books and videos. And that's another thing we are hoping to post by the end of this school year. So school's looking for some great books for any grade level on different environmental topics. Have a place they can go to look for options.
And with most schools now doing a one-to-one student ratio for laptops, having online resources is really important. A lot of schools are trying to go paperless, so that's good.
Yeah, and it's great. A lot of videos are you can find online, fantastic. So you don't need to always buy things. You can just
Excellent.
Fantastic. Well, we're again, folks. If you just turned in, we're speaking with Emily Fable, and she is with the Green Team Program Coordinator. She's with the Center for Ecotechnology. And she has a program lead there. And we're speaking also with C.J. McCarthy, my colleague at STEM Middle Academy in Springfield. And it's something I could just talk about forever. I mean, we're doing so much. And it's such a, you know, it takes an investment, at least in the school setting. And we want to talk about the business setting as well.
Yeah.
It takes such an investment on the part of everybody in the building. You
Absolutely.
Know, the cafeteria, the maintenance, certainly the students and teachers alike, you know, paraprofessionals, the administration. We've got a really great situation at STEM right now. Did you want to talk about... have us talk about STEM, or do you want to talk about business
first?
Yeah,
I first, know. With the Green Team, I mostly our help is remote, so I don't often get to be in a room with some folks working at one of the schools that we were interacting with. So I would just love to hear more about what you guys are doing, what your students are learning about.
Okay, sure thing. All right, well, first let me say, this is WXOJ-LP, 103.3 FM Northampton, streaming online at valleyfreeradio.org. All right, so let's talk about STEM. And well, first and foremost, why don't I start with, we're going to break this up a little bit, the motivation. And now our students came up with this agenda, which we're going to kind of share with you and give you some details. So this comes directly from our students. So the motivation has been stated at STEM Middle Academy for having a green team and doing all the recycling and composting and hydroponics and gardening, organic gardening, etc., contributing to our, you know, to our local homeless shelter as well. That is to make planet Earth cleaner, greener, and less polluted for the next generation. So our kids are, you know, kind of thinking
fantastic.
Ahead. Yeah, and I love how they wrote this too. So CJ, you want to talk about the structure of the Green Team?
Yeah, that'd be great. So the structure of the Green Team is all volunteer. It's run by the students entirely. Basically, the staff and the faculty in the school act as supervisors and assistants to the students. So they really take the initiative on that. They are the student leaders. They make the decisions. They vote on it. It's a democratic process. And then they basically implement the choices that they have voted on. So that's a really fantastic way for them to kind of, you know, start maneuvering civic obligations as well. Once they kind of make a decision, they roll it out to the school, they watch how it changes, and then we talk about it at Green Team every day and kind of make adjustments as we go along.
That's excellent. Like, how many students participate in your Green Team?
Consistently, there's at least 7 to 10, but some days we have, you know, upwards of 12 to 14, sometimes more. And then there's also support staff that are friends of the core students who help out in the cafeteria and the hallways and the classrooms, things like that.
Yeah. And your students meet every day?
No, once a week.
Yep, once
we
a week.
We meet weekly, like a typical club at the school.
Yeah, okay.
But the activities run throughout the week. So they empty recycling bins, they check composting, things like that throughout the week.
And I have a pull-out special education class, and sometimes, you know, we meet on Monday, so it's a holiday. You know, I'll just kind of take one of my smaller classes, and we just, you know, we'll do the recycling on my floor. And CJ takes first floor, I take the second floor, you know, leading kids around. All right, go ahead. Yeah.
So one of the other things that is a structure of the STEM team is community outreach. So we also take food that is donatable down to Worthington House. It's a local homeless shelter, and they basically benefit from the lunches that the students don't consume. So
that's great. What sorts of things do you bring down?
Muffins, fresh fruit, fresh vegetables, milks, I believe, all sorts of breakfast foods, cereals, things like that.
Yeah. That's great.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and like we said, we've got the buy-in from the administration at the school. Our principal, Luis Martinez, I believe, was he an environmental science major?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah.
Yeah. So he is like hook, line, and sinker, you know, behind us and supporting us. Our nurse, Ruth Mahoney, is our other coordinator, and science teacher Jamie Cairns as well. And Ruth is. Has a great relationship with the cafeteria. Jamie picks up the leftover salad bar waste, and that goes into our organic garden.
Mm-hmm.
And then we all kind of oversee the lunches for the food scraps. You know, we have two big barrels with the recyclable bags, and we have a separate dumpster, you know, that, where all that goes.
Yeah, I mean, just seeing the more... mindful students, you know, how much more mindful they become of where their waste goes during the school day, and then thinking about that in the classroom, and then hearing about how they think about that also at home too. It's really carrying over into other parts of their lives.
Yeah, and we're talking about, you know, emptying all the milk and juice and all that into a separate bucket.
Oh, that's great.
Before they recycle their,
oh, that's so nice.
You know, their juice and milk containers.
So heavy.
You know,
I mean, if you put that in the trash, your trash is so much heavier and so much more gross.
Yeah, yeah.
If you just collect it separately. Really, it makes it nicer for your custodian.
Oh yeah,
and
yeah.
nicer for the people that come pick up your trash, and it's less weight that has to be hauled in a truck.
Absolutely. Speaking of weight, I've got some recent statistics. On January 28th, we recycled 20 pounds of fruit, 64 ounces of milk, 30 breakfast sandwiches, 50 pounds of compost. So that's 50 pounds that stayed out of our landfill.
Yep.
So that was... and then on the 30th, 21 pounds of fruit, 23 strudel from breakfast. Maybe that went to the shelter probably. Yeah. And then 152 ounces of milk, 55 pounds of compost. So we're pulling a lot
that's
out
great.
Of there.
Yeah.
And that, I think that goes to Brattleboro, yeah. that particular
That's great. That dumpster. You know, I think a lot of people, when they think of food waste, they know about the idea of composting, and that's fantastic, and we're really great when food scraps end up in the compost. But it's really exciting that what your school is doing is recognizing a lot of that stuff that might otherwise end up in the trash is totally edible. And, can have a home that isn't the compost. It's a better use where people are actually eating it.
So absolutely.
Very exciting to us.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, if somebody's hungry, they shouldn't be, if there's food available.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally. And, our next step, which we're working very hard, and we have the head of recycling in the Springfield schools, John Alphen, is really working hard to get cardboard trays, replacing our styrofoam trays.
Oh, great.
You know, we're looking for buy-in from the school committee. You know, to fund it, really, because John,
fantastic.
It might have to come out of his budget, but we're just looking to get it going, you know.
That's great.
It's very exciting.
Yeah, if your school's already diverting stuff to a compost site, if making that switch makes a lot of sense, because you can just put those trays right with your food scraps, and then it can be composted.
Absolutely. So, again, back to the student voice, and I might read this under composting. You don't have this, but CJ and I are looking at our... little agenda. I think I might have sent it to you, but the kids said they wanted to reduce the amount of waste that traveled to our landfills, including eliminating styrofoam cafeteria trays in favor of cardboard trays, create healthier soil and more nutritiously grown vegetables in the STEM outdoor garden by composting leftover STEM cafeteria salad bar food. So, they're eliminating... You know, the junky trays, they're creating healthier soil. I mean, they're just, the kids are just on this.
That's awesome. And do you guys use one of the compost bins from the green team? Or do you have one you got yourself? Or?
We have three bins, right?
Yeah.
So trash, compost, and then the...
In the cafeteria, we have compost bins that I believe we got from Green Team, but I can't remember. In my own classroom and some of the other rooms, we also have separate composting bins, which we provided, and those get distributed out to the outdoor garden. We use that for outside.
And then in your outdoor garden?
We actually built some with the students.
Oh, cool.
So we got old wood pallets, chicken wire. They don't rotate or spin or anything like that, but they are composting. They produce heat all through the winter. So,
oh, great.
Yeah, it's
fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah, and the classroom bins are the blue bins.
Uh-huh.
No, it's recycled.
Yeah, those
and,
are great.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So let's see. And I can't emphasize enough how much having even the and Ruth talks about it all the time. You know, having the cafeteria and the maintenance buy-in. Because, the maintenance people, they could just soon, they're busy, they got a whole building to take care of, whether it's during the daytime or second shift. They see a composting bin kind of overflowing, maybe we had a holiday, and, instead of just giving it the heave-ho, they'll come to CJ, myself, CJ, or Ruth, or Jamie, and say, hey, this bin is full, teachers do the same thing. Yeah, rather than just start throwing things out, they'll shoot us an email. I mean, the buy-in across the board didn't happen overnight. I think we've been doing this, as I said, for about three, four years. We started off with...
We had to build it.
We had to build it up from scratch, really. But it just keeps getting better.
Yeah, it's great. We've seen custodial staff in a lot of schools really take the lead, or even if at first they're not sure about whether it's going to be a nice program to divert things like food waste into a separate bucket. It might be, oh, does that seem like extra work? But most of them, once it's in place, they realize it's not any extra work. It's stuff they're moving anyway. And the whole process is cleaner and less of a mess once things are separated out, which makes their job less, you know, more pleasant.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, totally. I think it's important that our listeners hear that the kids stated they want to make the world a better place while contributing to the homeless population and to grow as many vegetables as we need to offer healthy organic vegetables in the STEM cafeteria. So they really want to, like, feed the community.
That's awesome.
Yeah, absolutely. They are very focused on providing back not only for their families but other families in the community. That really was a main focus for them of starting up the program, was just improving the city overall.
Yeah, it's so fantastic. So we could go on and on, you know, and just talk endlessly about this. But I do understand that we're pretty high level in terms of what's going on, in terms of a green team.
Yeah, you guys are doing a great job. There's a lot of really good green teams across the state, and I think you guys are one of them. And you're an example of a school that's doing a lot of different things and doing them really well, from the things you're doing to the cafeteria, to the classroom, to the garden in your schoolyard. It's all amazing. For schools that aren't that developed, I think definitely look at the green team. It's a great resource. You can get things like free recycling bins if you're signed up for the green team.
Awesome.
Or free compost bin if you want to build one yourself. That's always awesome. Yeah. But we also have ones we can offer that you can put in your garden and just get started right away.
Wow.
Yeah, so we've got a lot of resources on our website, information about how to start up a compost bin, how to start collecting food waste in your cafeteria. And we also, you know, when people have questions, we email and call to help give them the support they need to get things working at their school.
And by the way, that is, I'm looking at it right now, that is thegreenteam.org. Thegreenteam.org. You can register right there on the homepage. Teachers sign up for the Green Team today. And there's all sorts of, you know, great things here. Green Team kit, library and curriculum, equipment, recycling facts, all sorts of great things here.
And it's all free. Everything from the Green Team is free.
Yeah.
That's the magic word for teachers.
yeah, totally. All right. So we've got a few minutes left. Why don't we talk about recycling works?
Yeah.
You want to talk about that?
Yeah. So, you know, we've been really focused right so far this morning on the Green Team, which is helping K-12 schools throughout Massachusetts. But we work at CET with all businesses and institutions across the state on waste diversion issues. And the rest of that work is funded through a program called Recycling Works in Massachusetts. It's another program also funded by the Mass DEP. And it is a resource for any business in the state that is trying to either recycle something or find an outlet for reuse or find a way to divert some food waste that they're producing. We'll help those businesses figure out what to do. It's similar to the Green Team. Everything we do through Recycling Works is free. And it's open to any business or institution in Massachusetts.
Wow.
And we have a website with tons of information, recyclingworksma.org. And we also have a hotline. It's an email or phone hotline staffed every weekday. So businesses can call us up and say, hey, you know, I'm a restaurant. I've been recycling, but my food waste has been going in the trash. I'd like to change that. What do I do? And we'll help them out. If they're trying to find a hauler who hauls food waste because the one they're working with doesn't, we can help them with that. Any sort of issue they're having,
that's
we
great.
Help them out.
And if you just tuned in, as a reminder, we're speaking with Emily Fable, Program Lead at the Center for Ecotechnology and Green Team Program Administrator, as well as CJ McCarthy, my colleague at STEM Middle Academy in Springfield. Time is short. Let's see. How about
eco building bargains?
Bargains.
Yeah.
I drive by it on my trip to work every morning.
I've bought stuff there for house projects already.
Awesome.
Is that
right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, very cool.
No conversation about waste diversion with CET would be complete without a quick plug for eco building bargains. We are the largest used building supply store in New England. People donate whatever things they have from projects, things like doors, wood flooring, kitchen sinks, vanities, etc., and then they get sold through the store, so you can get really great deals on all sorts of things, and it keeps those things out of the landfill.
Yeah, yeah. And it's a huge building.
It's pretty big, yeah.
Yeah, and yeah. If you have older houses, craftsman style, things like that, they have, you know, unusual windows, framing, things like that, that actually fit the styles of the houses.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. Now, is that Armory Street in Springfield?
Yep.
Is that the actual name?
I think so.
Yeah, I know it's the Armory Street exit off of 291.
Yeah.
And it's down there on the right, just over the tracks or whatever that is right there, right? Yeah, mm-hmm. It's by the... Yep. Puerto Rican bakery.
Yes, right across the street.
Right there, absolutely. Right, yeah. Mm-hmm. So you want to check out that Eco Building Bargains in Springfield. All right, what else? We're down to like our last couple of minutes. What else would you like to fill our listeners in on? And again, thank you for doing this. I mean, it's like a constant battle, you know, to just like get it right. And, you know, so many different personalities and, you know, it stresses on time, being in a school setting, you know, it's tough. I mean, there are days where, you know, as I said, there's like a holiday or whatever, and I'm on my way out and I'm like, oh man, all right, let me grab some kids. You know, I have some kids that are like kept after school. I said, you want something to do rather than just be punished? They're like, yeah, totally. You know, and they just jump in and recycle a floor.
Yep. Yeah. I mean, it's always great to have many hands in there. You know, many hands make light work though. So if you have those scheduling changes, the more people you can get involved in any program, you're going to have it continuing, even though some people can't show up one day.
It's true. And, you know, one of the coolest things we saw when we did our videotaping the other day is older kids helping teach younger kids how to go through the line and put their food waste in the right bin and pour their milk off. And you could tell those older kids, those third graders, they were really proud of the job they were doing because they knew what to do and how to help these younger kids.
Yeah.
And it's just really, really cool to see kids teaching
kids. They're ready to be leaders.
Yep.
Yeah.
So, being leaders.
Yeah. And, you know, I would add, I've had, when we were kind of getting the whole, you know, scrap food waste thing going in the cafeteria, we needed to kind of sit on those lunch shifts, you know, to make sure kids are doing it right. And there's two barrels. So I'd be down there at times and I'd just, you know, grab one of the kids that I taught and pull out special education. I was like, Connor, do me a favor, will you? You know, go over there and direct. He's like, no problem. He just sets his lunch down and goes over. This is sixth grader in Paulette Special Education telling seventh and eighth graders what to do.
That's awesome.
You know, and he's like, do this and put this there and do that. I'm like, Connor, I was like, you know, go easy, will you? But the kids are like, you know, it was like they were doing it.
That's
so,
great.
You know, even the younger kids. All right. So, how would you like to? What would you like to say in closing? So appreciative.
I didn't prepare closing remarks. I would just say, you know, whatever you do, whether you work for a school or another type of business, or just at your home, pay attention to your waste. There's probably a lot of it that doesn't need to be going into the trash. And if you need resources to help with you, go to thegreenteam.org or recyclingworksma.com.
Yes, absolutely. And Mr. McCarthy?
Only to the teachers out there to keep, you know, bringing this into your classroom and really start using Green Team resources in your room for student engagement and trying to, you know, elicit more student action and community engagement from them. Thank you.
Yes, absolutely. And I want to say thank you again to our Northampton Community Television audience. Thank you to Dave for training me on these new cameras. And thanks to Al Williams for this great collaboration. Al Williams, Executive Director at Northampton Community Television. And for our Valley Free Radio listeners, we're going to listen to a little Masala Jazz, Sirinam Carlson and his family, which is our background music during this interview. And then go into this date in music history, an enlightening quote, and I've got some 45s sitting over there on the turntable ready to go. Again, this is Kickin' It for Peace, Culture, and Education, airing each Sunday morning from 8 to 10 a.m. right here on 103.3 FM Northampton. I hope you'll like my Facebook page and Northampton Community Television audience. And thanks so much, folks. We'll be right back.